What is going on, my beautiful ladies and gentlemen of the world? I hope you all had a great Thanksgiving time, at least those of you that are in the United States. I didn't. So much work. I hate holidays because I've never had a job that got holidays off. I was always working on the holidays, so many hours around the holidays, and it's just like, oh, it's holiday season? I'm gonna hate it. It's just how it is. But so that's why, you know, it's been a hot minute since I did a video, but I feel bad. Because I feel like every single time, like when I'm recording, and I go around and I play and I just do shit, nobody recognizes me, nobody knows who I am, everything's good. And then the second I stop recording, but I'm still playing because I'm trying to practice, I'm trying to get better, you know, whatever, I find somebody, inevitably, that knows who I am and I'm not recording. Like, I don't know if you guys, like if I do run into you guys, if you want to be recorded, if you're like, no, I don't want my videos posted, I don't want people to, you know, like, I don't want to deal with the comments that people are going to leave regarding me. Keep me out of that whole thing. I don't know one way or the other, but I kind of feel bad when somebody's like, oh shit, hey Nate, and I'm like, oh, hi. I hope you don't expect me to be recording right now. But anyway, thankfully, we have replays, which you have to initialize network mode first to even be able to access them. So I ran into Mr. Fire Necromancer. The reason, big reason why I recorded them, he's using Kagura. Now I know everyone, that's actually another thing too, on top of it. Is everybody that watches me just godlike? Every time somebody notices me now, it's just, I eat an ass beating. And I ate an ass beating here. Now a big part of it is, I've lost all familiarity that I used to have with certain characters about reactions to do with certain things. And so, like, I'm hitting buttons where I absolutely shouldn't. I am, trying to react to things, like, I don't think I blocked that overhead a single time. Stuff like that. And like that, me thinking like, oh sure, there's no way he's gonna come. See, I tried to block that cross up, I think. I'm doing everything wrong, and that is why I get my ass kicked. But I figure, you know, everybody is so down on Kagura that maybe y'all wanna see some Kagura. Because I know, you know, like, just the internet in general that I've seen is like, Kagura's unplayable, he's terrible, he's god-awful. And I certainly, you know, like, I remembered as I, you know, the more I played him, unfortunately it was a lobby of four people. And I'm really bad at being patient. I just want to play. And so that is one good thing that the, what's it called? That was a terrible idea. Like, that shit has so much recovery and the counter hit. Like, it's not just the fact that it has a ton of recovery, but the counter hit window is enormous. And that I fucked up. See, because I know exactly what combo I have to do, because 236D is one of his most important. Let me pause this real quick so I can talk. Susanoo's 236D, which is the very final unlock icon on his entire, on his little thing, is one of the most important moves in his arsenal for a variety of, number one, it unlocks 236D, which is just a fantastic move. It's a swinging, I think it qualifies as a projectile, I'm not sure, but he just kind of summons a sword and swings it, and it, like, encompasses about 75% of the horizontal area in front of him in the screen. Like, it's incredible, its hitbox. And then he also unlocks a new distortion, which is 236D, and it's basically the same thing, just bigger. And it gives you massive damage, it gives you huge corner combos, it's one of his most important moves to be able to unlock. And so, I have a combo path that I know how to do if I unlock something on a 5D. And then I go on from there, and so, like, but I haven't really played enough, like, I took a long enough break thanks to the holidays and stuff that I forgot. It kind of slipped my mind, like, oh shit, I need to be doing this, and so that's where that came from. I really do need to play more, because my Susanoo just isn't good. And I need to get there. See, like, that, good god. I mean, see, a lot of Susanoo players that I've seen kind of treat, that was good bait, by the way. A lot of Susanoo players kind of treat 6A as a little bit better than it actually is. And the problem is, like, it is good. It's very, very fast. But the problem is that there is a ridiculous amount of whiff recovery to it. And so if you do manage to make it whiff, you're gonna have some life problems. I mean, the big problem is, like, purely and simply, I'm just running into shit. And it's giving him, I mean, you see that did almost 5k right there. Like, that's not something you just want to eat. I think right there, I would have to go back and check my buttons, but if I remember correctly, I think I tried to, because one thing I've been trying to do, especially because with Susanoo, like, unless you've unlocked his DP, you kind of don't have, you don't really have any defensive options. And so I've been trying to, see, I kind of fucked it up right there, and that's why it blue beated. Because what you're supposed to do there, instead of doing the whole, that was stupid of me to keep going. Anyway, instead of doing JB, first hit a JC, jump cancel, JB, both hits a JC, JD, you just do JB, jump cancel, JB, JC, and then the JD will always give you 236D. And yeah, I fucked that up. Also, he was good with OD. Like, he, one big thing about, well, kind of just about this game in general, is you can't consistently do, you cannot become predictable with your block strings. And right now with Susanoo, I am very predictable with my block strings. I keep doing, because I started to play, my entire point was to try and, to get into using 6B a whole hell of a lot more, because I'm not. I do like 5B, 2B, straight into 5C. And like right there, a 5B counter hit just straight into what basically constitutes Magic Series. What am I doing? Because what am I doing with my life? I don't fucking know. And so it's stuff like that that I need to fix, that I need to get better at and stop doing. And so that was kind of the entire point of me playing. But then I ran into him and it's like, oh shit, good player. All thought goes out the window and I need to be like, see that? Look how fucking far that hits. That's amazing. And that did almost 3.5k. Didn't that start with an A button? Like, holy shit, that distortion is some scary stuff. Oh yeah, so anyway, so I've been trying to, let me just, now that we're far past the point where I meant to actually say it, because all the characters I played previously kind of had some kind of defensive answer that I could utilize to some degree. Tager's always had his backdash, like, it got nerfed a little bit. I can't remember if it was nerfed in Chrono Phantasm or if it was nerfed in Chrono Phantasm Extend, but it's still a very good backdash. Azrael obviously has his godlike backdash. He had Growler in Chrono Phantasm, and now he has whatever his DP is called in this game. Bullet had her DP. Like, I've never played a character that really just didn't have anything defensively until Susanoo. And so if you don't unlock that second slot, which gives you 623C, which is does have invincibility to it, you're shit out of luck. You gotta block. And so I've been trying to actually start to use, what the hell are they called? I don't even know, the fucking alpha counter stuff, where you press forward and A plus B. I've been trying to use those more, and I think that's what tried to happen when I got hit in the middle of the block string, was I meant to do that, but the block stun didn't actually last long enough, and so then I just got hit instead. But I've been trying to use those more with Susanoo, and I was trying to work on those against this guy. Did I try to do it right there? No, it's not in there. I guess I just got hit. Because I know, like, that was kind of the scenario where I'd be looking for when I'm stuck in the corner. I don't really have any other answer. Oh, maybe I tried to DP that, because I did have DP unlocked. Also, is there some nuance to you two Kagura players out there in the world? Fire, you're one of them. Is there some kind of tell that tells you whether or not he's going to go behind you with that, or if he's going to stay in front of you? I need to be using more throws too. And I also need to be special canceling that. Like, there's no... I just don't do it. I don't know why. Like, there's no reason not to. Because the thing is it's not even like... Oh no, if I can't special cancel this into something... it'll be an unsafe hit confirm, right? Like, it either hits and you special cancel and then you get the special move. Or it absolutely... Or they block it. And you can't special cancel. I mean, it's unsafe in the first place, but you can't special cancel it off of if it's blocked anyway. So like, there's no downside to just always special canceling that move. But right now, I just don't do it. Why did I record this one? Did I accidentally do this? I think I can't remember if I just recorded it because it was Kagura. Did I record it because he has the Guilty Gear colors and I don't know how the fuck you get those? Not the Guilty Gear colors, but like the PlayStation, because PlayStation Plus members in Exard's sign got those colors. I don't know if they're in Revelator. And they put them in Blaze Blue, but I don't know how to get them. And somebody tell me how, because Hakumen's version of that color is actually godlike. I really like it, because it basically, I mean, it kind of, it's the same. His sword looks just like Ragnar's, and it basically makes it look like he's using a lightsaber. But yeah, why did I record? I think I just recorded it because he was using Kagura. Because he was switching around between characters a bunch, depending on who he was playing. He did stick with Kagura with me the entire time, so hopefully that meant that at least I am dangerous enough to require the use of his main, and it's not just like, I don't want to disrespect this motherfucker, because I know who he is. And I wouldn't be disrespected at all. Like, I don't... If you want to pick an alt and beat my ass and show me how much I need to improve, please do. I will never, ever get insulted at a loss. I will never feel, like, get angry because you trolled me. Because ultimately, if you are sitting there, seriously, why did I record this? If you are sitting there trolling me, you're not doing optimal shit. You're not playing to the best of your ability. And if I can't even beat that... That's a problem that I need to correct. And so the onus is on me to do so. It's not on you to, like, be nice and cuddly and fucking shelter me from how bad I actually am. Show me. Let me know so that I can, you know, definitively understand these are scenarios where I need to improve because right now I look like an idiot. I have no qualms with that whatsoever. And I never will. See, like, right there, it's just, that's terrible for me to just keep doing that. Especially against somebody who has continued to prove that they're so willing to use Overdrive Raid to begin with. I was actually surprised, like, I think that seems to have a shit ton of durability to it. But yeah, I mean, everything with Susanoo, I need to work on so much. Blocks as he did it again. That's twice in one round, and it's this exact same scenario. I just keep doing 5B, 5C. What did I try to do there? Hang on, you can't rewind, can you? Can you? You can't. Why would they? Whatever. Finish. I wanted to go back and look at my inputs to see what I actually did there. Because I must have had a plan, right? I would hope. There you go. There's my 1-6-B. The entire point of me playing was basically to work on utilizing 6-B, and I used it once. Goal achieved. Yeah. Oh, this has devolved in such bad, like, mashing. Oh, I remember this. I meant to... God damn it. What did I mean to do there? I just remember being so angry at myself because that should have been my round. There was no reason for me because I assume JD probably, like, looking at his health afterwards, I'm pretty sure JD would have just killed there regardless. But I was kind of just watching it and like, ah, shit, I probably need to do like an extended block string, or not an extended block string, an extended aerial combo here. What can I do to finish this dude off? And I was thinking about like rapid canceling into another J8 or JH into another JC, but then I wasn't sure if it would work, and then I just didn't do anything at all and choked so hard it made me really, really sad. It was just I hate it when I do that. I hate it when you lose purely based off of your own badness. And this is not a good time for me to be playing, by the way. It's before noon. How is it so early? My sense of time at the moment is just completely fucked because my schedule has been like, I've been working such long hours that like, I kind of am used to, okay, I start at this time on these particular days and I end at this time on each of those particular days. And so at the very least, I kind of tend to know about where I'm at in my day, depending upon several different factors. Holidays, like I said, I've been working so goddamn much, that just has been thrown straight out the window. Come on, yes! And now we get to sit here for 70 seconds. I think I know that person. ZYXXLulz? I think I know who that is. If only these were actually four bars. Why did I breed so many Sneasels? I've been playing a lot of Pokemon, too. Because I basically, like, when I get home, I'm just so goddamn tired. I don't want to do anything but just, like, fall over and chill. That's all I want to do. And Pokemon is great for that. Fuck it, let's just go. Just go sit over here and chill. See what happens. But so I've been getting into... Because I've never really dealt with breeding all that much in these games. Why do you keep getting neutral natures, you suck? And I am really starting to get irritated with the whole nature mechanic and... One of the first things I tried to do. I think my favorite new Pokemon in Sun and Moon is Salandit. But the one I got out in the wild, because they have it so that males do not evolve and females do. So why would I want a male? I need a female. But the actual like ratio is something like 80% males, 20%, something like that. Like, it's massively skewed towards males. So it's already hard enough to find a female. And then on top of that, you have to worry about what its nature is. And so, you know, does it actually suit your goal for its moveset and all this shit? And so, like, I tried to breed them. And it was like, oh, man, cool. This one has a high Z disapproval. Does that mean we have a shit connection? Aw, one bar. How do I cap this? I really need to just learn how to do this. Where's caps? What does that say? L1? L... Holy shit, my eyesight is terrible. Doesn't it say... Oh, okay, I was just gonna say, like, why are both of those on L2? That makes sense. Is there there's a lowercase one in there? I don't even care. I have no idea which buttons are which on the stick. Like, I have to look every... I know X is the bottom left. That's it. I don't know what triangle is. I don't know what L1 or R1 are. I always just, I know which buttons do what in all the fighting games that I play, but I don't have a goddamn clue where they actually are on the stick. Oh, is Tsukuyomi, are you match standby? Nah, damn it, they played. I need to beat this person's ass. Take their yellow. Also, it's a 3-bar connection, so that's good. It just sucks. I wish it was a better time. Because this is the time that I do have to record, but unfortunately, it doesn't look like we're going to get anything good. I guess I should just do that, right? Like, I should have a bunch of, just a bunch of replays on standby, so in case stuff like this does actually happen, I have something to do. But yeah, so the good thing about it is, like, because I kept breeding the Silent Dits, and they kept coming out male, and their natures were all over the place. But some of them had natures that I wanted, just, you know, wrong gender. Fuck that! Please go away! Are you just here to troll? I can just sit here and stare at my DS all day. And so I actually found out a lot about breeding. Like, for instance, you can equip a specific Pokemon that you put into the, like, whole breeding center place with an Everstone. And then there's, I guess, a 50% chance that that specific nature that that thing has will be passed along. And so then it removes at least a portion of the RNG, makes it much more in your favor to get what you want. But yeah, it's the one thing, like, the more I delve into Pokemon's kind of more expansive mechanics, the more I find that I dislike. And it's not really necessary, it's everything they put in, everything they have is kind of like, there's some good stuff going on here. But I have this issue, and this issue. Like, everything has positives and negatives. There's nothing that exists that's just like, oh yeah, this is really cool. This entire system is cool. I always find problems with everything. So, like, for instance, in this game, I don't think they've done this in a previous Pokemon game. They have scaled experience based upon your dude's level in comparison to the dudes you're fighting, which it's a good idea, and it really does work out. Hey, look at that. We're talking about Kagura. We find a fucking Kagura. It's a good mechanic, but the problem is that you have, you know, you can go up to level 100, but they don't have wild Pokemon that go up to level 100 to support, you know, like, constant scaling, so you fight whatever level you want to get up to. They only go up to, like, level 60, and so, you know, the further away you get from 60, the less experience you get until you're basically getting nothing, and it just creates a massive grind to try to get your Pokemon anywhere above that, and it just sucks. Nailed it! Why would you not do the follow-up? Oops. That didn't punish really. I fucked that up. That's one big thing that, like, if Kagura isn't covering his Oki with a fireball, it's free to just, like, wait for him to do something. I actually tried to detect that. Okay, so that was bad, because he basically hyped for, oh, wow. Wasn't expecting that. Too busy talking, I'm not paying attention to what's actually going on. What? I'm not sure why that hit me. I need to remember that as armor. I was so, like, I just completely lost focus throughout that entire round, and that's why I got perfected. I mean, this character is so heavily momentum. Like, he has a bunch of shit that just kind of works. See, like that. Like, that's his Berserker Slash. It's just invincible for no good reason. Why did my other shit not come out? Okay, he just keeps doing it. Oh, that's cool. I don't know what's happening. I want to keep grinding this out and I can learn this matchup. Because the thing is like, this isn't some unbeatable, like, cheap shit that he's doing. It's not like, oh, there's no answers to this. I'm just doing the wrong thing at every single turn. Every time I do something, I'm doing it badly. And it's because, a large part of it is just, I'm still so uncomfortable with Susanoo. I haven't played him consistently enough. Like, I'll play 3 matches here, I'll play 5 matches there. I haven't really just been able to sit down and don't fucking switch. Oh god, I hate people that do this. Nothing you can do about it, but it's just like, you didn't curb stomp me so badly that like I have no chance whatsoever and it's just boring for you to play that character. So like, you know, and you go back in, it's, oh man, I want to learn this Kagura matchup, and then they switch a character and it's, fuck this. Now I'm just gonna beat them and then I'll switch to Azreal. And then beat them even worse. Oh, I thought I would. I would really legitimately would have thought I'd get over that. Okay. God, his pokes are so slow. How did I not block that? That's quite interesting that I didn't block that. God damn his fucking dash. That was supposed to be 2C, I just didn't hold 2 because I'm an idiot. That was dumb of me. It's interesting how that missed. I don't know why I did that. I should have done 60 right there, and then it would have comboed. But see, I mean, my Susanoo's just bad. That didn't even hit from there, huh? Interesting. Oh, that's right, that's air unblockable. Okay, so he just keeps rolling. So I'm gonna do nothing but grab on his wake up. How the fuck did I get 6A? Okay, so I didn't know he could jump cancel that. I thought that was just straight unsafe. I mean, this is all like matchup shit. I'm letting him bully me instead of me bullying him. But see, like, how all he's doing is jumping? And I should be blowing that up. Like, he doesn't have any actual legitimate movement. He's just constantly jumping, and I'm allowing him to. What the fuck? Hate his dash! He's just jumping! Why did I even try to command grab? God, my Susanoo's so bad. I'm gonna spend so much time off camera just working on this dude. Because where I am right now, I'm terrible. I'm awful. There's no getting around it. I don't anti-air properly. Like, I mean, against someone like... I have lost to a lot of people who play just like this person. Who never spend any time on the ground. They never actually do anything. They just constantly jump around and throw out jump-ins. And I let them because I'm not anti-airing. Which is terrible. I need to be. That's the way you beat these people. But now I'm going to do the same thing you did to me. Because fuck you. Made me goddamn mad. I'm gonna take it out on you. I hate it when I forget to get something to drink, though. I forgot to grab some water or something. And so now it's like, at the end of this, you know, I've been talking for a while. Starting to feel it. It's in the back of my throat. I know, like, my mouth is getting dry. Starting to get that cotton mouth. No fun at all. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Oops. Oops. That was just supposed to be a 5A because he keeps doing the same shit. Okay! I don't know why I didn't get a... Oh boy. All of my characters are scrubby now. I just don't play enough. How the hell that hit me? Like, why don't I just play this character? He's just so good. He's so much better than Susanoo. I just get to do whatever the hell I want. Can't do that with Susanoo, because once you're putting block stun, you're just like, alright, I gotta sit here for 20 seconds and just wait until there's a 23 frame gap for one of my normals to manage to get through. It's just so bad. But with Azreal, fuck that. Backdash, DP, 5A quickness that has an amazing hitbox. Just fuck it. Let's really fuck with him. I do actually think that Tager can do quite well in this. Because I actually won. I will bet you money that I can 360B that, like, spear dive move. If I time it properly. That's a big if, because she can delay the timing. Like, it isn't just a consistent, this is when it's going to come down. Oh, I tried to sledge again. I forget that, like, she just kind of naturally blows that up. Oh, cool. I screwed that up. Oh, okay. Ow. Is that an overhead? Apparently that's an overhead. I was not aware. Because that first hit whiff, and then I just got blown up. What? Oh, I did tech. Well, at least I tried to tech, I guess. Wait, Aw, I wanted the counter hit. I deserve that. Come on, Tager, have anti-airs that work! Oops, I'm just sitting there mashing. I'm so mad. I'm like, God, 360C is such a bad move. Okay, yeah, I can't do anything after that. Which sucks, obviously. Okay, yeah, that's an overhead. Man, this dude... This is the perfect character for this dude. Like, just literally hitting every button possible. Okay, that's an overhead. I don't know that that's an overhead. I did 5D, and she moved nowhere. Oh, boy. I'm actually, like, just with how badly 360C interacted with her throughout that entire thing, and then that 5D, like, she remained stationary. On 5D. Oh god, that's such a bad character. I'm so mad. Oh boy. All right. Well, thank you for watching. Why I just need to like I talk badly about Susanoo all the time. But I have more fun getting destroyed as Susanoo than I ever have with Tager, period. Oh god.